Would you believe that the Canon EOS R5 overheats in a fridge with an ambient temperature of 4 degrees Celsius or 38 degrees Fahrenheit from taking 60 JPEG images? Canon's also getting ready to announce a new RF mount cinema camera, and the Panasonic S5 announcement date is revealed. Let's get into it. Hi, I'm Simon. Thanks for tuning in to The Ordinary Filmmaker. If you're new here, subscribe to get notification of new videos like this one so you don't miss out on any news. And all the links to everything I talk about in this video, including gear discussed and the Canon EOS R5 giveaway contest details, are placed in the description down below, along with my affiliate links, which help support this channel. So if you're looking into buying camera gear, accessories, or anything like that, please consider the links down below to Downtown Camera, B&H, or Amazon.com. Andrew Reed just put the Canon R5 in a fridge to further follow up on the overheating issue, testing if it's possible to extend the record times when the camera's kept in winter-like conditions. Well, Canadian winter-like conditions. Andrew used the Canon R5's intervalometer to take a JPEG every minute. Now, no video was recorded during this test period, just 60 stills during the elapsed hour. At the halfway point, Andrew decided to check how much record time was available in 8K after just shooting 30 stills for 30 minutes inside the fridge. You're not going to believe this, but only 5 minutes of 8K video would be recorded, or that's what the camera was saying. You could only record 5 minutes of 8K video, despite the internal temperature of the camera being 34 degrees Celsius. Now, after another 30 minutes, 60 minutes in all, he checked how much 8K video could be recorded. Guess how much time was left to record in 8K with an internal temperature of 34 degrees Celsius? Zero. That's right, zero. And the R5 then displayed the dreaded overheated shutting down message, and then shut down. Andrew went on to say that the camera externally was as cold as a beer bottle, and internally far below the temperature it's happy to record 15 minutes continuously in 8K on a hot summer's day. Something fishy's going on. How can the Canon R5 overheat with an internal temperature of 34 degrees when it can record 15 minutes on a hot summer's day? What's clear from recent tests by Andrew and others is that the overheat warnings are not based on the internal temperature alone. There are other variables at play. These findings lead people to believe that Canon is artificially restricting 8K video, 4K 60 video, and 4K HQ enough to make it useless for any serious work in these video modes. And if this is your opinion, I really don't blame you, because that's where the current observations are leading us. But it could also be some sort of bug. Perhaps some variables meant to keep the camera safe under heat were not properly set up. But the R5 was in the hands of beta testers for months, along with popular Canon ambassadors like Peter McKinnon. If this is a bug of some sort, or Canon's being overly cautious, it should be fixed in the next firmware update. However, if this is a result of Canon restricting the capability of advertised features, features that didn't have any sort of warning in marketing materials, features that Canon claimed were based on heat buildup, and not, you know, that press statement that Canon issued shortly after it was announced, which appears that this isn't exactly the case, well, Canon could be exposing themselves to some sort of legal risk or legal jeopardy. Artificially restricting a piece of technology isn't new. It's done all the time. But promoting and selling said technology based on video modes like 8K, limiting those capabilities on environmental factors that are suspect, and then stating that the reasons for the restriction is heat when several tests from different people produce results countering Canon's claim not only create legal risk for Canon, but also create bad press resulting in lost sales and cancelled pre-orders. Do people producing these tests have an ulterior motive? Is the truth somewhere in between? I think Andrew sums it up very well. If the EOS R5 is able to shoot 15 minutes of 8K with internal temps showing 46 degrees Celsius in a warm room of 27 degrees, why can't it shoot 8K whatsoever in 33 degrees Celsius in a fridge? This is after no video recordings whatsoever and just 60 JPEGs being taken over an hour. Even the back of the camera, which sits millimeters from the processor and RAM, was cold to the touch with no hotspot. The CF card was also cold to the touch after removing it from the camera. The cripple clock seems to tick down to 0 minutes over the same time period of 60 minutes, just as it does so in a room of 23 degrees C or outside in the blazing hot sun of 35 degrees C. Andrew feels that Canon owes him an answer, as he bought the Canon R5, and I tend to agree. There's something definitely going on here, and the only way to make it go away is for Canon to clear the air, communicate the issue, Why is this happening? And what can be done, if anything? And until they do, this isn't going away. But what do you think? Do you believe these latest test results? Do we now have a crippled clock to contend with, or are there some bugs that need to be addressed in a firmware? Let me know in the comments section down below. Now, on to cinema cameras. Last week, Canon Rumors reported that two Canon Cinema EOS R or RF mount cameras would be coming soon. Today, Craig received an update that only one of the Cinema RF cameras will be coming out this year and will likely be announced in September or October. The camera to be announced will be the Canon Cinema EOS R300, as it was christened by Craig. These are the specifications for that camera. Super 35mm 4K sensor, same in the C300 Mark III, no IBIS, RF mount, it gets 10 internal stops ND, 10-bit 422 with C-Log2 and 3, 4K 120, 2K 180, no RAW capability internally at launch, it'll use SD cards and it's going to be priced at $62.99. Subscribe and you'll get updates as they happen. Adobe has added support for the Canon R5, R6, and the Sony A7S III in Adobe Photoshop and Lightroom. I hope Apple's not too far behind with an update for Final Cut Pro. Now in the update, Adobe supports these following bodies and lenses. The RF 85mm, the RF 100-500mm, the Canon 600mm, the Canon 800mm, and as you can see, this supports both extenders, the 1.4 and the 2.0 times. Panasonic will announce the Lumix S5 in a virtual event on September the 2nd. I'm personally very curious to see how good this camera is, but like you, I'm most curious in the autofocus performance. Will they move to phase detect or stubbornly stick to depth from defocus autofocus and continue to make improvements as they have with each camera? Time will tell. If you want to be the first to get one of these, the pre-order link is in the description down below. All right, just a quick update on behind the scenes. I want to talk to you a little bit about lighting. Yesterday, I put a call out for you guys to give me some suggestions on lighting. And as you can see from this video and the one I published earlier this morning, I have made changes. And I've made those changes because of the input you guys have given me. So thank you very much. I've been saying this for months, but I think I've got the best, the smartest audience on YouTube. I really do appreciate everything you guys do to help me, from your comments to your suggestions, and just how you participate in the channel. This very much feels like a community where we can come together to ask questions and help each other out. So thank you very much for that. But that's it for now. That's all the news that I have for you today. Don't forget to subscribe for your chance to win the Canon EOS R5. That's right, I'm giving away the Canon EOS R5. All you have to do is subscribe and you have a chance to win. I do have further details in the description down below. Thanks for watching The Ordinary Filmmaker. We'll see you again soon.